Hello dear students, welcome back. Now this is the third and last video of the poem An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum, and in this video we are going to discuss the question answers. In the first two videos we have discussed the poem, so listen carefully to the discussion of the question answers. So we are starting with the think it out exercise given in your book, and the first question is: tick the item which best answers the following. Question A is, the tall girl with her head weighed down means the girl is ill and exhausted, has her head bent with shame, and has untidy hair. So in this first option, that is ill and exhausted, is correct. She was exhausted and tired because of her troubles and miserable life. So option 1 is correct. B question is, the paper seeming boy with rat's eyes means the boy is, option 1 is given, sly and secretive. Second option is thin, hungry and weak. And the third option is unpleasant looking. So as we know through the discussion that the boy was paper seeming because he was very thin, hungry and weak. So the second option is correct. The third question is, the stunted unlucky hair of twisted bones means the boy, first option, has an inherited disability. And second option is, was short and bony. First option, has an inherited disability, is correct. Now D question is, his eyes live in a dream, a squirrel's game in the tree room. Other than this means the boy is, first option given here is full of hope in the future. Second is mentally ill. And third is distracted from the lesson. So his eyes live in a dream supports the first option, that is, he was full of hope in the future. E question is, the children's faces are compared to rootless weeds. This means they, first option, are insecure. Second is, are ill-fed. And third is, are wasters. Correct option is, are insecure. Now, insecurity here stands for that nothing was clear about their future. So, they were like rootless weeds. Now, the second question is, what do you think is the color of sour cream? Why do you think the poet has used this expression to describe the classroom walls? Well, the answer to this question is that the color of sour cream is off-white. The poet has used this expression to suggest the decaying aspect. The deterioration of the color of the classroom walls symbolizes the pathetic condition of the lives of the scholars, the children of the slum school. Third question is, the walls of the classroom are decorated with the pictures of Shakespeare, buildings with domes, world maps, and beautiful valleys. How do these contrast with the world of these children? You may write in the answer that the pictures that decorate the walls hold a stark contrast with the world of these underfed, poverty-stricken, slum children living in cramped dark holes, and obstacles hamper their physical and mental growth. The pictures on the wall suggest beauty, well-being, progress and prosperity, a world of sunshine and warmth of love. But the world of these slum children is ugly and lack prosperity. So this is how these pictures contrasting with the world of these slum children. the last question is, what does the poet want for the children of the slums? How can their lives be made to change? Well, the poet wants the people in authority to realize their responsibility towards the children of the slums. All sorts of social injustice and class inequalities be ended by eliminating the obstacles that confine the slum children to their ugly and filthy surroundings. And he wants them to study and learn to express themselves freely. Then they will share the fruit of progress and prosperity, and their lives will change for the better. So this is all about this poem, dear students. I hope that the poem is clear enough in your mind. When you will get the books, you can have the self-reading of the poem for the better understanding. Thank you.